Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Armin. Today I want to show you how to model a Helmholtz resonator in COMSOL Multiphysics. I will create the resonator geometry in COMSOL and use ports in the acoustics pressure physics. With ports, we can easily calculate the sound transmission loss. Also, you will learn to model sound absorber materials in resonator. Please watch the video till the end. Let's get started. In the first step, I'm going to click on the model wizard. The model is three-dimensional, so I'm going to click on 3D. We need pressure acoustics because we want to perform an acoustic analysis. When we click on the study, it will take us to the study window. In the study, I will select the frequency domain and click on the done icon. After these steps, we will go to the model builder. I will change the unit to millimeters because the resonator dimensions are in millimeters. First, I will create a cylinder with a diameter of 40 millimeters and a height of 500 millimeters. In the geometry tab, I will click on the cylinder and enter the radius and height. Also, the cylinder is in X direction. Now is the time to create the resonator neck. The neck is in the middle of the tube, so 250 millimeters should be moved in the X direction. The diameter of the cylinder is 10 millimeters and the height is 40 millimeters. The neck is inside the tube, so I will move it 20 millimeters in the Z direction. There is a gap between the neck and the tube. I have to fix it this way. I want to merge two cylinders. Therefore, I will select the union from booleans and partitions. I have to uncheck Keep Interior Boundaries to remove intersected zones. Resonator volume is a cylinder. I will select a cylinder and enter the radius and height. I have to put it on the top of the neck. Finally, I will merge all cylinders by union tool and uncheck Keep Interior Boundaries to remove intersected zones. It's time to define material. I will right-click on Materials and select Add Material from Library. We can find air in the built-in pressure acoustic physics needs sound speed and density of air. This is pressure acoustics physics. I need one port for input and another for output. I am going to select the inlet of the tube and change the type of port to circular. Also, I will enter 1 Pascal for pressure amplitude. We have to specify 2 reference points. As before, I will define another port for the outlet. Note that the incident wave excitation of the second port is off because it is an outlet port. As you see, the maximum element size depends on frequency, so I will specify the frequency interval in study 1. I will set the maximum frequency to 1000 Hz with a 10 Hz step. I go back to Mesh and click on Build All. Mesh is a little coarse, so I will set the element size to fine. The model is prepared and ready to be computed. I will click on the Compute button. The solution is completed. Now we can see the acoustic pressure and sound pressure level. However, I need to calculate the sound transmission loss as well. Therefore, I will add a 1D plot group. After that, I will select Global by right-clicking on it. I'd like to change the name of the 1D plot group to Transmission Loss. I will click on Global, select Add Expression from the Y-axis data, and choose Transmission Loss. I will change the description to correct the legend. Resonance occurs in 171 Hz. There is a simple analytical formula to calculate resonance frequency. I entered the parameter's value before, and the result became 179 Hz. The difference in the results is 8 Hz. The formula is calculated based on a one-dimensional wave, and our modeling is three-dimensional, so this difference is normal. Let's add sound absorber material to the resonator. First, I will create a plane on the resonator and move it down 30 mm. I'm going to change the plane type to face parallel and click on the top of the resonator. Then, by using the partition objects tool, I will split the resonator. Now there are two domains. I will add a Porous domain and select domain 2. There are several models available for porous materials, but I will stick to the default one as it is simpler. Material is air. We have to enter flow resistivity either in material properties or here. I think 1000 is suitable. Note that the Delaney-Basley model only predicts results upper than 0.1 value of flow resistivity in Hertz. Therefore, results above 10 to 1000 Hertz are reliable. I will generate the mesh again and click on Compute. Okay, here we can see pressure acoustics and sound pressure level. This is transmission loss with a porous material. The peak frequency has become 161 Hz and 10 Hz lower than the previous result, because the sound absorber material has reduced the volume of the resonator. I want to compare results, so I will add another study. I need a frequency domain. Also, it's better to change study 1 name. I want to disable the Porous Acoustics domain, so I check this box and disable Porous Acoustics 1. I will copy the frequency range from study 1 and paste it into study 2. Finally, I will click on Compute. I would like to see the transmission loss in one graph, so I set the dataset to None. In the Settings window of Global 1, I will set the dataset in Study 1. This is transmission loss of resonator with absorber material. In the description, I'm going to write Porous. For simplicity, I will duplicate Global 1 and change the dataset to Study 2. Now we can see two results in one graph. Sound transmission loss is overestimated without absorbers, as there is no damping to control the solution. Therefore, the solution with absorber materials is more accurate. The port can calculate the reflection and transmission coefficients. To determine the coefficients, we need a 1D plot group and a global. In the y-axis data, I will click on Add Expression and find the scattering coefficient. S11 is the reflection and S21 is the transmission coefficient. I'm going to add both. In the description, I edit the names displayed in the legend. Note that you do not click on Replace Expression because S11 will be deleted. The transmission loss can be calculated by the transmission coefficient according to this formula. The transmission loss obtained by both methods is similar. The tutorial has ended. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel.